Hello students, I hope all of you are fine at home. Today I am here for class 8, subject biology, chapter 1, crop production and management. And my today's topic is irrigation. Now, all living beings need water to live. Water is important for proper growth and development of flowers, fruits and seeds of plants. I hope you all know this. Water is absorbed by roots of the plant. That is, water is absorbed by plant roots. Along with water, minerals and fertilizers are also absorbed by the roots of the plants. Next, water is essential for germination of seeds. Water is very much essential for germination of seeds, for proper growth of seeds. Nutrients dissolved in water get transported to each part of the plant, and these nutrients are very much essential for the proper growth and development of the plant. To maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crops, growth, fields have to be watered regularly. So, to maintain, to grow proper and healthy crops, the soil has to be remained moisture and the fields have to be watered regularly. So, from our previous discussion, we concluded that water is very much essential for the growth of the crops. So, now we will say the definition of irrigation. What is irrigation? The watering of the crops. The watering of the crops at different intervals is called irrigation. Next one is drip system. And the third one is lift irrigation system. So, the three methods, modern methods of irrigation are sprinkler system, drip system and lift irrigation system. Now students, we will learn about the sprinkler irrigation system. Now, in the sprinkler system, it is useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. Now students, you look at the picture of the sprinkler system carefully. In this picture, you can observe that the perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on top are joined to the main pipeline at regular intervals. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipe, under pressure with the help of a pump, it escapes from the rotating nozzles. It gets sprinkled on the crop as if it is raining. Sprinkler is very useful for sandy soil. Now students, our next system is the drip system of irrigation. It is also useful for water deficient regions. It is the most economical method of irrigation. Now students, you look into the picture of the drip system. In this system, you can observe the water of the roots. So it is called drip system. It is the best technique for watering fruit plants, gardens and trees. The system provides water to plants drop by drop. Water is not wasted at all. It is a boon in regions where average